Well, here we are at the Josephine County Fairgrounds, Grants Pass, Oregon. It's Saturday, August 25th. Time for the Rat Rod Show. First, we'll take a quick pan down the aisles and then see if we can find somebody to interview. Sommerfeld, he gets to be our first victim today. Hi, Bob. Nice to meet you.
What do we got here?
Looks like it says 28 Dodge.
Right. So,
it's a 28 Dodge.
It's
a
36 Deluxe.
It was.
It's like a walkabout.
Yeah.
Well, first thing I want to know, Bob, is what made you decide to do this?
Well, I had all these parts laying around my shop. I had a rear end, I had an engine sitting on the engine stand for 8 years. I figured I might as well put this stuff to use. I had transmissions, everything. So I just found the frame of the body and started building a car out of it. That's what I come out with.
Now, so you started off with your engine. Kind of needed something to do with it.
Yeah, it's
what do you got in there?
350 that's been punched 30 over. It's a 4-bolt main. 327, 350 horse fuel cam, Offenhauser intake, MSD distributor, and a 680 Holley, or 780.
Can you run 780 cubes through that motor?
No, I probably.
Or CFM, I mean? Yeah.
Well, it has been. I haven't checked my gas mileage. I just put that on there. I had a 600. I might go back to it. But it, it seems to jump a little higher with this.
Now, where'd you get those headers?
I did some trade to a guy, traded him a bare Chevy block for those headers he had hanging on the wall. Somebody made them for a pickup, and they dipped them in porcelain.
Yeah.
And they wouldn't fit his, so I did some trading with him, and I made him fit this.
Okay. Now, you got that thing working there, that horn?
Oh, yeah. The button's right here.
Well, that's a good place for a horn button. Readily accessible.
Yeah, couldn't reach it down here. Not enough room in there.
So you're, now the instrument cluster.
It's all aftermarket.
If I can open the door here.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. Close that door. What do you call that there? What's that shim?
These are Model A door handles.
Okay.
Ford Model A.
I'm just trying to make.
And I had to have this shim to put them on because they're curved here.
Yeah.
And I found this at a steel yard and asked them what it was. They had a piece about 1.5 long. They said they'd make railings out of that.
That's what it looks like.
Whatever works.
That's what it looks like, with railing. That's what rat rods are, huh?
Yeah.
I'll let you open that.
Because it's an old car.
So now for your instrument cluster,
it's all like aftermarket out of Napa. Parts house.
So you just made a piece of aluminum plate.
Yeah, that's a piece of stop
on the back side.
It's a piece of stop sign.
And then you got your 1970s Dodge steering wheel there.
Well, that is off a AMC Javelin steering wheel. And I just ground the AMC off it and put a decal of a Dodge. for Dodge.
So worth more than the whole rest of the car, huh?
Yeah. Just about. Swap meet material.
So what'd you grab for a seat?
That's the back seat out of a Dodge minivan. It has to be the right width and the right price. So
take it.
Yeah. And the headlights are Dodge Power Wagon. That's about all the Dodge that's on it except for the frame and body.
Well, your Power Wagon.
I'm not sure. It's the old, like a GI rig, Dodge Power Wagon. It's the headlights set up on top of the fenders.
Okay.
The headlight brackets are off a plow.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
Oh, right. It's a Vega steering box.
So how'd you get this nice patina on there? It kind of looks, has reminiscent of muriatic acid.
Well, I sprayed rust killer on it. And then it set in rain.
Well,
and then
Bob, I hate to tell you this. It didn't work.
No. No. Well, but it doesn't seem to be rusting anymore. But I don't get it wet. I'm afraid to.
And this is your camper, too, because you stuck this mattress across the roof.
Right, right. It's a half-inch piece of plywood.
And I kind of hate to tell you this, but didn't anybody tell you that padding's supposed to be on the inside?
Not on this.
Good place to camp out, though.
Yeah, yeah.
If the need arises.
Especially when the sun's shining.
I don't know what this is. Oh, I know what it is. I see what it is. Stuck a whole new door panel on here?
No, that's somebody, evidently at one time, somebody tried to steal this skin.
Oh.
It was cut. And they cut it so fine that you couldn't hardly see the cut.
Ah.
But that's what makes it welded together, and it's full of lead. So once it got the lead out of there, it stuck it together. Several bullet holes.
Yeah, are those authentic bullet holes, Bob?
Yes.
Oh,
this one over here went through here, come out here, went through the top of the dash.
Let's follow this trajectory here. Whoops, come on, camera. Well, now my camera went completely out of focus. We'll have to edit this out. Now we're going to talk about his pinstriping.
Yeah, I just had that done over here.
I know. How much did that run you?
$80. Headlights, dash, cones, back end, taillights.
That's a bargain.
I thought that was a pretty good deal.
It's a good deal.
I got an old 48 Chevy. I had striped in a show and it was 125. He didn't do the dash or anything.
Yeah, we got a shot of that on the dash already. Some around door handles. Some more of the authentic bullet holes.
Doesn't take much. I know.
Okay, we got to know, how fast have you had it?
Oh, I've had it about 105. Just cruising down the freeway. What?
It wasn't scary yet?
Oh, no. Oh. Smooths out about 100.
Just gets into cruising mode around $100 bail. So what'd you do for a windshield? I know that can't be original.
No, I couldn't find a windshield frame, so a friend of mine and I made that one.
You made this? Now, yes. Is that laminated?
Yeah, it's regular safety glass. We cut it out, set it in there, and glued it in.
Now, the black here is what?
Paint.
Just painted it on?
On the inside? Yeah.
It's not between the laminates?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, but painted the inside. It's called Fusion Paint.
Okay.
And
more or less like the newer cars, you know, you got the black rim.
Right. Now, even your caulking looks old.
Yeah, well, that's just the way it came out. But this kind of covers up the doodads where, you know, it's supposed to have a chip-out windshield if I had a windshield.
Right. And your visor almost looks original.
It is.
Wow.
Only thing I did was change, put new screws in. I didn't even take it clear off. It's got the same patina in between.
So where'd you snag that 28 body? I mean, how many years ago, and had plans for it or what?
I got it in February of last year.
Oh.
And pulled it out of the garage January of this year. It took me 11 months to build a car. Found it in Napa, Idaho. Well, my nephew found it for me. He lives there.
Now, what'd you say you had running for a rear end?
It's a Ford 9-inch out of a big van, big Ford van.
Okay.
350 turbo tranny.
And then your front brakes are what?
This is an axle. 56 Chevy pickup. Turned around. Flip-flopped. On a pickup, this is in the back.
Right.
Turn the whole axle and everything around.
So what's that do for your caster?
Well, then I set the grease
the way you,
in the axle.
The way you put it in the...
And then the toe in. As far as the axle being, it's straight.
Okay.
66 Ford Mustang fit right in that 28 Ford grill shell. I got a few Ford parts, a few Chevy parts.
Well, these are rat rods.
Yeah.
And, pretty clean, though.
This is, you get a cup of antifreeze here.
Yeah.
It goes for the gas tank, it's a Miller gas tank.
Yeah. All right, Bob. Nice car, nice job.
Thank
Glad
you.
To see you out enjoying it, and let everybody else enjoy it, too.
Thank you.
Jeff. Hi, Jeff. My name's Jeff.
How's it going?
All right. What do you got here? What year is this?
It's a 1934 Chevy five-window coupe with a 12-valve Cummins twin-turbo diesel in it.
Well, it used to be a Chevy five-window coupe.
Yeah,
it
used to be.
So where'd you pick the body up at?
I found it out river off Evans Creek, actually, out in the Tula Weeds.
Oh, nice.
So
did you get it for a song? Oh! I think I'm getting that on camera. So did you drive it here today?
Yes, sir. Drive it every day.
That grill's a little low, ain't it?
Oh, yeah. Picks up off the ground. It's got air ride all the way around.
Oh, okay.
So, yep.
We haven't gotten that far yet. Yeah, I noticed your front suspension here is not like anybody else's that I've seen.
They have a beer thing for their...
So where's the air ride on that?
No, the air ride's inboard here. There's airbags right there.
Okay.
They lift up on these shackles and pivot on the inside.
Okay. So who came up with that design?
Me.
Really?
Double case of beer.
No. You and Miller Genuine Draft, huh?
Yep.
So a turbo Cummins. I imagine it gets out of its own way pretty good.
Yeah, it flies. Absolutely moves out.
So, yeah, I see your frame is right on the ground, isn't it?
Yep.
So were you looking to do something like this when you found the body? Or
I just wanted something different, something that nobody else had. So, of course, there's a several of them across the United States that have Cummins in them, but no one in our area has got it like that. So.
And you got you a nice big sheet of copper across the top.
Yep.
Pick that up at the scrap yard? Or?
Oh, yeah. White seat metal.
So did you... do your own chop and channel on this thing?
Did everything. Built the whole thing. Seats, fuel tank, tunnel, hairpins, drag link, everything.
So you had an idea of exactly what you wanted to do before you ever started?
Yep.
You find the body before or after your ideas?
No, I found the body and the motor and tranny all in one day.
Really?
Yep.
Just all fell together? And
loaded it all up and took it home with me.
Fired up the welder and went to work, huh?
Yep.
KW. Now, once you do something like this, what do you have to do with the DMV in order to get it registered and licensed?
Have proof of bill of sale of motor and tranny, bill of sale of the body, bill of sale of all the receipts for the steel and everything that's fabricated.
Okay, did they have to inspect it at all?
Yeah.
And they were all smiles, said, man, this thing is great.
Yeah,
here you go.
I don't know about that.
So made you jump through some hoops, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I wish we had the chance to fire it up and drive it and take it down the road and smoke the tires on it, but we can't do that here.
Nope.
All right, thanks, Jeff.
No problem, man. Appreciate
nice
it.
Machine.
Thank you.
Bob.
Oh, okay.
This is Bob Sommerfeld. He gets to be our first victim today.
Hi, Bob.
How you doing?